The Swamis are very dear devotees of Sri Mahaprabhu. Among them, six Goswamis were very famous. So Raghunath Bhatta Goswami was one of them. First, we will see Sri Goswami of stock by Srinivas Acharya. Then, I'll speak on Raghunath Bhatta Goswami in both languages. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is mention about Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. Danda pranama kori bhatto kori na charoni. Danda pranama kori bhatto kori na charoni. Prabhu Raghunath boli kaila दंड प्रणाम करी भट्ट पड़ा चरणे प्रभु रघुनाथ बोली कहला आलिंगन रघुनाथ भट्ट गोस्वामी वॉज कमिंग टू नीलाचल पुरी धाम फ्रॉम वृंदावन बाय वॉकिंग व्हेन ही केम टू पुरी मेट श्रीमन महाप्रभु ही प्रोस्ट्रेटेड इन साउथ एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ श्रीमन महाप्रभु एंड महाप्रभु एट वंस पिक्ड हिम अप फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड and embraced him and addressed to Raghunath. When he got the embrace of Sriman Mahaprabhu, he got ecstatic feelings, very delighted he was. And all his pains he had faced during coming, walking, went out immediately by the touch of Sri Mahaprabhu. When Raghunath Bhatta Goswami was coming and the way he was thinking, I was going to meet Sri Mahaprabhu after a long period of time. I cannot think of whether Sri Mahaprabhu would recognize me or not. I was thinking like that. But when Mahaprabhu, with smiling face, uttered, "Oh, Raghunath," picked him up from the ground and embraced him. So, shedding tears of joy, Raghunath Bhatta Goswami said, "Oh, merciful Lord, you have still remembered me." Then Mahaprabhu said, "Raghunath, I cannot forget the affection of your parents. But to speak up in this life, in many lives also, I cannot forget. How can you forget you? Because when Mahaprabhu was in Kashi, he was taking prasadam in the parents' house of Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. That is Savan Mishra's house. You understand? Then Mahaprabhu introduced Raghunath Bhatta to other Vaishnavas there. All were very happy to see him. Then Raghunath conveyed the dandavat of his parents. While coming, his mother had given him very nice preparations, some cakes, some laddus, some nice things, very sweet, nice things for Mahaprabhu. She had prepared enough, just a bag, a very big bag of foodstuff. It's known as jhali You understand? He said, Jhali, very big bag. So Mahaprabhu was very much happy and asked Govinda, please take all these things, keep it in our room. The father's name of Raghunath Bhakta is Tavan Mishra. Do you understand? He was an inhabitant of East Bengal, Purva Bengal. He was a great learned Pandit. No, Shastra, very well. He was thinking seriously about Sadhya Sadhan Tattva. You understand? Sadhya Sadhan Tattva. Specific word. Don't you know Sadhya Sadhan Tattva? Sadhya Sadhana Tattva. What is sadhan? And what is sadhya? Sadhan means process of cultivation of this devotional service or spiritual things is sadhan. And what is its result? The sadhya tattva is known as sadhya sadhana tattva. The specific words, you must know all these things. These are specific words. Don't always expect to speak on English on this sadhya sadhana tattva. You understand? Some specific words you must know. You understand? Don't forget. You are Vaishnavas. Vaishnavas know all these things. All right. He was thinking about seriously about sadhya sadhana tattva. You understand? In one night he saw a dream. One Devingar came to him in the dream and told him, "Oh, Mishra, why are you thinking so seriously? And why are you so disturbed about that? About sadhana tattva? You go and approach Nimai Pandit. He will explain you very nicely about sadhana tattva. मनुष्य नयन तेह नर नारायण नर रूपी लीलाकर जगत्कार दैट निमाई पंडित इज नॉट एन ऑर्डिनरी ह्यूमन बीइंग इज नर नारायण यू अंडरस्टैंड नाउ ही हैज एडवेंटेड हिमसेल्फ हियर इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ होल वर्ल्ड ही गो एंड अप्रोच सो इन द मॉर्निंग He finished all his morning duties, bathing, etc. Then started for the meeting of Sriman Mahaprabhu. He saw Nimai Pandit was sitting. He looked very effulgent. You understand? And his eyes were like the blossomed petals of lotus, and on his head there are curling hairs, very nice looking, blossomy, and in the chest, white sacred thread, Subhra Govita, and he had put on yellow garment, cloth. Tapan Mishra prostrated himself at his lotus feet and with folded hands said, "O merciful Lord, I am very dino, I am very dino, low, distressed." Do you understand? Dino, dino bond. Dino bond. His friend of the distressed. I am dino. Please have your mercy on me. Mahaprabhu smiled and allowed him to sit there and inquired about his identity. Who is he? Then Tapan Mishra gave his own identification and asked about Sadhya Sadhana Tattva. Mahaprabhu said, in every yuga, his yuga, is Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga. In every yoga, for the benefit of the living entities, this Supreme Lord incarnates himself here. And he teaches himself how to do bhajan of the Lord. You know the word bhajan? You know bhajan? Bhajan, yes. Chanting bhajan. Yes. Krishna bhajan. You understand? Yes. In Satya Yoga, Yug Dharma is meditation, dhyana. You understand? Treta, Yug Dharma is yajna, sacrifice. And Dwapar, deity worship, paricharya. And Kali Yuga, it is the name Sankirtan. You understand? Kali Yuga Dharma Hoye, Nama Sankirtan.
Kali Yuga Dharma Hoye, Nama Sankirtan.
Kali Yuga Kali Dharma. Like that. So, this is Kali Yuga. So, Yug Dharma is Naam Sankirtan. And all must follow it. Ato yego Kali Yuga Naam Yogya Saro.
Ato yego Kali Yuga Naam Yogya Saro.
धर्म कहले नहीं होए तारो
आर को धर्म कहले
तो मां प्रोसीड लाइक दैट मेंशन इन चैतन्य भागवत इन कलि युग इस नाम यज्ञ इज युग धर्म. So in this yoga, if you don't do nam yajnam, you cannot understand the sadhya sadhana tattva. This is most important. So, discarding all other desires, giving up all other desires, always chant this, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram,
Ram Ram, Hare.
He instructed like that. And the effect of this mantra, Maha Mantra, is so that it will reveal you this tattva, sadhya sadhana tattva. This Harinam is sadhya and also sadhana. You understand? This is sadhya as well as sadhana, dharma. Because nama nami abheda. There is no difference between the name of Lord Hari and Lord Hari himself. None difference. Then Kapal Mishra could understand everything, prostrated himself at the lotus feet of Srimad Mahaprabhu, Nimai Pandit. Nimai Pandit was then preparing itself to go to Navadip. So, Kapan Mishra expressed a desire to go with him to Navadip. But, Nimai Pandit told him, you go to Kashi, go back to Kashi. Again, you'll meet me there. I'll go to Kashi afterwards. At that time, I'll give you some more tattva upadesh. You understand? Tattva upadesh, you understand? Some more instructions on it. You understand? Then Pavan Mishra went back to Kashi with his wife and stayed there because he was the inhabitant of East Bengal. First I told this. You understand? So, according to the direction of Sriman Mahaprabhu, my Pandit, he went to Kashi with his wife and stayed there. In the meanwhile, Gaurahari took up sannyas. And by the request of his mother, Sasimata, he stayed in Nirathav Dham, Puri Dham. He was going to Vrindavan, but his mother said to stay here. So he stayed here, in Puri Dham. After staying a few months in Puri, then he went to Vrindavan through Jharikhand jungle. You understand? By walking through the Braj. And on the way he went to Kashi, way to Vrindavan. In Kashi there was a ghat, there is a ghat known as Manikarnika ghat in river. You understand? Kashi is a confluence of three rivers, Banaras, Kashi, Prayag, Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati. And there is a ghat known as Manikarnika ghat. Do you understand? Bedding ghat, like that. Famous ghat, Manikarnika ghat. And Srima Mahaprabhu was taking his bath there. No, he was there chanting, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. And at that time, Pavan Mishra was taking his bath there, in that ghat. So immediately, all of a sudden, hearing this, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, he was startled, Pavan Mishra. Because at that time, nobody in Kashi was uttering this Hari Bol or doing Krishna Sankirtan. Because that was the period of Mahabhadis. And Prakashananda Saraswati was the guru of all Mahabhadi sannyasis there. When he heard Hari Bol, Hari Bol, the sound, and saw a very beautiful looking young sannyasi. And he thought of, by the effulgence of that sannyasi, all directions were effulgent. So he started thinking, who is this sannyasi? Is he the Nimai Pandit of Navadvip? I have heard that he has taken up sannyas. Then, getting out of water, he saw that, yes, is that Nimai Pandit, now a sannyas. He could recognize him. Then he prostrated himself at the lotus feet of Srimad Mahaprabhu and cried. Srimad Mahaprabhu lifted him from the ground and embraced him. After a long period of time, this meeting was there. Then Tapan Mishra invited him, Srimad Mahaprabhu, to his house. He washed his feet and the whole family drank that water. You understand? It washing water. And the son of Tapan Mishra is this Raghunath Bhatta. He was a very small child then. And that child, Raghunath Bhatta, was sitting at the lotus feet of Sriman Mahaprabhu. Then Mahaprabhu did that baby, Raghunath Bhatta, and put him on his lap. Then Tapan Mishra arranged for cooking. And Balabhadra Bhattacharya cooked food for Mahaprabhu. Then Mahaprabhu took his bath. At the bath, he took prasad. The remnants were given to Tapan Mishra. Very much. The baby son of Tapan Mishra, that is Raghunath Bhatta, was messaging the legs of Srimad Mahaprabhu. So after taking prasad, Srimad Mahaprabhu took rest. In Kashi, Srimad Mahaprabhu was staying in Chandrasekhar's house and eating in Tapan Mishra's house. I told, in Kashi, Mahabadis were great in number. They say Brahma, Atma, Chaitanya, no Krishna. They never say Krishna. Brahma, Atma, Chaitanya. You understand? Then Mahaprabhu came to Kashi, so this Nam Sankirtan began there. The Maharashtra Vipra, the Maharashtra Brahmin, requested Srimad Mahaprabhu, "Oh Lord, please deliver this Kashi. My bodies are there." The Guru, the spiritual master of this sannyasi, Mayabadi sannyasi, Prakashananda Saraswati, he never utters the name of Krishna. 3 times, I told your name, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. But 3 times, he said only Chaitanya, not Krishna. The Mahaprabhu said, the Mayabadis are Krishna Aparadhi. They have committed offense at the lotus feet of Krishna. So they cannot utter the name Krishna. You understand? The name of Krishna and deity of Krishna and Krishna himself is form. All are spiritual, Sajidananda Maya. There are no difference between these 3. You understand? He instructed like that, Srimad Mahaprabhu. Then the next day, Mahaprabhu started for Vrindavan. And when going to Vrindavan, he said, "If Krishna saw us his mercy, all the inhabitants here in this Kashi, all the Mayabadis will be delivered." He just told and started for Vrindavan. So in Vrindavan, Mahaprabhu spent some days with much delight. Then again came back to Kashi. So once there was a meeting between Mahaprabhu and all the Mayabadi sannyasis headed by Prakashananda Saraswati. The description is given in Chaitanya Charitamrita. I need not describe all these things. Anyhow, by Mahaprabhu's mercy, all Mayabadis, sannyasis, with their spiritual master Prakashananda, were delivered, became Vaishnavas. You understand? They saw that Mahaprabhu was looking very effulgent, very beautiful, and is very, very, humble? Humble? Yes. So all the sannyasis perceived his feet. And they all glorified him. Chanted glories of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This time there was tumultuous Harinam Sankirtan. You understand? It flowed like a inundation. You understand? लाइक एन इनंडेशन, इनंडेशन ऑफ परिणाम बनी. अंडरस्टैंड? देयर वर ऑल माय बाद फिलोसॉफी डिसअपीयर फ्रॉम काशीपुर. अंडरस्टैंड? This time Mahaprabhu stayed 10 days in Kashi. Tapan Mishra, Chandrasekhar, Maharashtra Vipra, Maharashtra Brahmi, and other devotees sat Srimad Mahaprabhu nicely. And Raghunath Bhakta, the son of Tapan Mishra, also served Srimad Mahaprabhu for 10 days. Then Mahaprabhu took leave from the devotees and started for Puri. All the devotees there felt very sorry, thanks of separation from Mahaprabhu. And this Tapan Mishra son, Raghunath, cried loudly, catching the lotus feet of Srimad Mahaprabhu. Srimad Mahaprabhu picked it up and just coaxed him and said, "You serve your Vaishnava parents. At intervals, you would go to Puri. There we'll meet." Then Mahaprabhu embraced Tapan Mishra, Chandrasekhar and other devotees there and gave many instructions. Then he took leave and started for Puri. In the meanwhile, Raghunath Bhakta grew up and had his education. Within a very short time, he became a great pandit in grammar, background, we say, grammar, alankara, shastra, then some. Alankara Shastra is literature. Kavya, you understand? He became a great pandit in this literature, Shastra, and served his old parents. Then after a few days, then Raghunath grew up. So Tapan Mishra told him, "Go to Puri and meet Gaura Sundar." So Raghunath became very glad, excessively glad. Then Raghunath's mother prepared very nice preparations, full bag, that I had told you. Taking the blessings of his parents and with that bag, Raghunath started for Puri with a servant. The servant carried the bag. On the way, a devotee of Lord Ram met them. His name was Ram Das. You understand? He was a government servant. And also, he was a professor. That Ram Das took the dust from the feet of Raghunath Bhakta and took away that bag from the servant and himself carried, put on his head, that Ram Das. The Raghunath Bhakta said, "You are Pandit, what are you doing this thing?" Ram Das said, "Bhatji, I am a Sudra, the lowest Sudra. You understand? Just I am serving a Brahman, thereby earning some good fortune, security. You understand? You understand?" Then Raghunath said, "Panditji, I request you, please give that back to my servant. Please don't carry." But he didn't listen to him. He carried himself. You understand? So on the way, both Raghunath Bhatta and that Ram Das discussed on many topics of Shastra. So, at last there is Tripuri. Then Raghunath Bhatta came and met Srimad Mahaprabhu, prostrated himself at the lotus feet of Srimad Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu picked him up from the ground and embraced him. Then he asked about his parents, how are they doing? Asked about Chandrasekhar and other Vaishnavas in Kashi. And Raghunath gave detailed information about them. Then Raghunath took that Ram Das before Srimad Mahaprabhu. Not Ram Das paid Dandavat at the lotus feet of Srimad Mahaprabhu. But Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Lord. He knows the heart. That Ram Das had Mukti Kamana. Mukti, do you know? What do you know? Mukti.
Desire for liberation.
Yes, Mahaprabhu could understand that he had desire for liberation. So Mahaprabhu didn't like him so much. Then he ordered Raghunath, go and take bath in the sea, ocean, and go Jagannath Darshan. So with a devotee, Raghunath Bhatta went to the ocean, took bath, then went to Jagannath temple and saw Lord Jagannath. Then came back to Mahaprabhu. In the meanwhile, Mahaprabhu had taken his prasad. The remnants were given to Raghunath Bhatta, that is mercy. Govinda, his servant, Mahaprabhu's servant, gave that remnants to Govinda, as Raghunath Bhatta, Mahaprabhu's remnants. And Mahaprabhu made all arrangements of staying and taking prasad and that. Raghunath Bhatta in Puri. At intervals in some days, Raghunath Bhatta himself was cooking for Mahaprabhu and was inviting him for prasada. Raghunath Bhatta this time stayed in Puri for 8 months. And They spent very happily in the association of Srimad Mahaprabhu. Raghunath Bhatta saw the dancing, chanting, dancing of Srimad Mahaprabhu for Lord Jagannath. It was so transcendental and extraordinary. Then Mahaprabhu ordered Raghunath Bhatta to go back to his parents and serve them. And Raghunath Bhatta thought of the separation from Srimad Mahaprabhu. He was a bit distressed. But Mahaprabhu gave him nice instructions and said, don't marry. Don't accept a wife. Don't marry. Serve your old parents. And again come here. And we will meet here again. And have a darshan of Lord Jagannath. Then he, taking up his own mala from his neck, Mahaprabhu, put it on in the neck of Raghunath Bhatta. You understand? Then Mahaprabhu sent some good deal of Jagannath prasad through Raghunath Bhatta to the devotees there in Kashi. Then Raghunath Bhatta paid his prostrations self life in lotus feet of Sriman Mahaprabhu. While taking leave from him, Mahaprabhu took the palm and embraced him. Feeling the thanks of separation of Sriman Mahaprabhu, Raghunath Bhatta started for Kashi. So coming to Kashi, Raghunath Bhatta served his old parents according to the instruction of Sriman Mahaprabhu and also studied Srimad Bhagavatam in the association of Vaishnavas. When his old parents disappeared, Raghunath Bhatta, according to the instruction of Sriman Mahaprabhu, didn't take a wife, didn't marry. He went to Puri Dham, to the lotus feet of Sriman Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu became very glad to see Raghunath. And Mahaprabhu also glorified the qualities, good qualities, noble qualities of his parents. And Raghunath Bhatta spent his days delightfully there, the association of Sriman Mahaprabhu. 8 months went, gone. Spent 8 months there. Once Mahaprabhu called Raghunath Bhatta and said, "You go to Vrindavan. There is much to do in Braj Bhumi. My mother ordered me to stay here, so I couldn't do anything in Braj Bhumi. But I'll do that work through you in Braj Bhumi. Go back, go to Braj Bhumi, Vrindavan." When Raghunath Bhatta thought of that, he'd go to Vrindavan, leaving Sriman Mahaprabhu here, he felt the pangs of separation and was very much distressed. Mahaprabhu could understand this. So he said, "Don't be distressed. You will meet there Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami and stay with them and have their association and discuss and study Bhagavatam from them. And you will enjoy." So according to the direction and order of Sriman Mahaprabhu, Raghunath Bhatta started for Vrindavan. He prepared himself to start. He took leave from other Vaishnavas. Then at last he came to the lotus feet of Sriman Mahaprabhu to take leave. At the time of leaving, Sriman Mahaprabhu gave Raghunath Bhatta Sri Jagannath, Lord Jagannath's very big garland, very long, 15, you see, 15 cubits long, very big garland he gave. And also Tambur Mahaprasad. Tambur, you know, palm. And embraced Raghunath Bhatta. And Raghunath Bhatta went to Vrindavan through that path through which Mahaprabhu had gone, through Jharkhand. You understand? So on the way, he could see the Mahaprabhu's footprints or something, places related to Mahaprabhu's Leela, and also was hearing some glories from the people there in that, on the way. So at last he came to Vrindavan. The Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami were very much glad to see him and they embraced him with love. They welcomed him. All the Goswamis were very happy. And they loved Raghunath Bhatta as if he was their brother. Raghunath Bhatta had many good qualities, very humble, many Vaishnava qualities, he was a Pakka Vaishnava. So all were very much pleased with his behavior. And he was studying and Srimad Bhagavatam and also reciting the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam in the association of Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, while studying Srimad Bhagavatam, he was feeling ecstasy. And all the symptoms, shedding tears, erection of the hairs on the body, asasattika bhav, asrukampo, gudgudo, choking of the tongue, and speak, and then stand. And when tears were rolling down from the eyes, he couldn't read, and the tears are there in the eyes. This is bhav, mood. Raghunath Bhatta had very sweet voice, like cuckoo's voice, very sweet, cuckoo's voice. And he was chanting the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam very sweetly, nicely. Raghunath Bhatta then was engaged in the service of Govinda Dev, Lord Govinda Dev. Nirupa Goswami's deity, Govinda Dev. And he built a very nice temple, this mandir, for Govinda Dev, by the help of one of his wealthy disciples. And also he made the mukut, the bansi flute, the kunda, earrings, all these for ornaments of the deities. And at intervals, while he was remembering Srimad Mahaprabhu, he used to put on that mala on his neck that Mahaprabhu had given him. He was always engaged in the service of Govinda Dev and always engaged in the discussion of Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna Katha. He never listened to any political things, Grami Bharata. He never speaks. All the time was spent on Krishna Katha. You understand? In Gaura Ganadesh Deepika, it is mentioned about him that Raghunathakya Kino Bhatta Puraja Ragamanjari. That means, in Braja Leela, and he disappeared on this day, this Ashvino Mas, Shukla Dwadasi. Yesterday was Ekadasi, 2 days Dwadasi. You understand? 12th day, bright for night, this day. On 1579 AD. You understand? And he stayed. His living period in this planet is 75 years. This is all about his divine life. Jai Sri Raghunath Bhatta Goswami Prabhu Ki Jai. Mantha Kalpatur Vishwa Grubhati Vishwa Patitani Vishwa 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 Vishwa